قيامة الصلوات الواجبة الخمس قصور وعدم اهتمام قبل شهر رمضان. بعد شهر رمضان الإنسان بدأ يصلي الصلوات الخمس في أوقاتها، هذا علامة قبول صيامه وقيامه. إذا أصبحت أخلاقه طيبة حسنة مع زوجته مع الإخوان، إذا أصبح قلبه نظيفا طاهرا لا يحمل حقدا على أحد، إذا أصبح لسانه لسانا طاهرا لا يستغيب ولا يكذب ولا يتهم ولا يتفحش وكذا، نعرف بذلك أن الله عز وجل قبل صيامه وقيامه، وإلا ما لازم يكون هناك تغيير. الآن صفحتنا بيضاء والحمد لله، الله تبارك وتعالى ليلة العيد أي كليلة القدر صفحتنا بيضاء، ينادي منادى من بطنان العرش أن الله غفر لصائم هذا الشهر الكريم، صفحتنا كلها بيضاء.
صلى على محمد وآل محمد.
بيضاء بيضاء كالثلج. إلى السنة القادمة 335 يوم، صح ولا لا؟ اليوم شفت رواية إخواني أعزائي أخواتي من الإمام المعصوم صلوات الله وسلامه عليه، الإمام يقول سنتك العبادية تبدأ من أول يوم عيد الفطر إلى السنة القادمة. هاي الصفحة البيضاء اللي صارت بيضاء بيضاء، ها صار لا شو صفرها بيضاء بيضاء، احنا شلون راح نسودها؟ نسودها ولا ننورها؟ هذا يعتمد على علامة قبول الروزين. ما علامة شبتشية كأجر يك تحول وزور لشغل در زندگی ما، اولا از نظر عبادت نمازها رو در وقت بخون. اگر جوانی از ما نسبت وقت نماز و به نسبت به نماز قبل از ماه مبارک رمضان سستی داشت، الان میبینی اول وقت نماز میخونه، ساعت میذاره برای نماز صبح ظهر از وقت وقتش شروع میکنه نمازشو میخونه. اگر دیدیم از نظر اخلاقی، از نظر اخلاقی اخلاقش خوب شده، با دیگران اخلاقش خوب شده، با دیگران حرف قشنگ میزنه، زبانش زبان طاهر شده، تمیز شده، غیبت نمیکنه، دروغ نمیگه، فحش نمیده، تهمت نمیزنه، معلوم میشه اینه که خداوند تبارک و تعالی روزش رو قبول کرده. باید یه تحولی بشه و الا مشکله ها ماه مبارک رمضان بیاد نیاد، اگر کل سال ماه مبارک رمضان باشه ها ولی هیچ اثری نکرده ابدا، فقط به سکر روایت های اهل بیت علیه السلام فرمودن که فقط و فقط تشنه شد و گشنه شد سر سفره ما شاء الله نشد غذا خورد و سیر کرد خودش، همین چه قیمتی داره. باید انسان تحولی در زندگیش، در کردار، در گفتار، در غذا، در لباس، در کل شی، در کل، در همه چی بایستی انسان فرق کنه. روایت داره از اهل بیت علیهم السلام فرمودن، حضرت فرمودن سال شما از روز عید فطر شروع میشه، سال عبادت، سال توجه به خدا. در روایت هست شب عید که مهمترین شب هاست بعد از لیال القدر، و در روایت در یک مقامی با لیلت القدر هست منادی از عرش خداوند تبارک و تعالی ندا میاد، خداوند تبارک و تعالی از همه بندگان روزدار همه بندگان توبهشون را قبول کرد، لباس لباس طاعتشون عملشون قبول شده. الان به شمار میکنم دفترشون تمیز سفید سفیده. حضرت میفرمایند بعدن باید چه کار کنیم؟ آیا این سفیدی میمونه؟ این تمیزی میمونه؟ اگر لباسی شما داشته باشی سفید سفید یه نقطه سیاهی در اون لباس باشه از طرف سوال میکنین که لباس من چطوره؟ میگه چرا این نقطه سیاه هست تو لباست؟ بابا لباس کامل چند متری ها شما ندیدین سفیده، چرا این نقطه رو دیدین؟ ما باید عوض کنیم. علامت قبولی روزه هامون خیلی اهمیت. یک، نسبت به نماز، نسبت به قرآن، یادمون رو قرآن بخونیم، با قرآن بهش ما قهر نکنیم. دوباره ما مبارک رمضان میاد دوباره آشتی میکنیم با قرآن. نه نه عزیزم، قرآن قرآنه، اقلتا روزی 50 تا آیه، اینم فراموش نکنیم. این علامت قبول. لذا حضرت امیر فرمود در اینی که عید چه عیدیه؟ اگر امروز بنده روز عید فطر، فردا، پس فردا، این هفته گناهی نکردم، گناهی خدا نکرده انجام ندادم، اون روز عیده. این روایت هم بگم و تبو میکنم. خسته شدین از حضرت امام حسن مجتبی علیه السلام، ایشون فرمودن، ایشون رد شدن با یه مجموعه از جوانها، اینا نشستن عشق دارن میکنن، میخندن و میگوین و دیگه عیده خداش اینا. حضرت نگاه کرد بهشون، فرمودن که عجب چطور اینا اینقدر خوشحالن، نمیدونند که خداوند تبارک و تعالی آیا عبادتشون قبول کرد، روزهاشون قبول کرد یا نه. اینا در غفلت هم. العید ليس لمن لبس الجديد، مثل ما واحد يلبس جديد يعطر كل واحد منكم يشتري لنفسه والجهاله ملابس جديده يلبسهم، هذا للبدن. للروح شنو؟ هم لازم نلبسها ملابس جديده. نسال الله تبارك وتعالى لنا التوفيق. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. انا انزلناه في ليله القدر وما ادراك ما ليله القدر، ليلة القدر خير من ألف شهر، تنزل الملائكة والروح فيها بإذن ربهم من كل أمر، سلام هي حتى مطلع الفجر. تقبل الله أعمالكم بالصلاة على محمد وآل محمد. أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم، وصلى الله على محمد وآله الطيبين الطاهرين. أسعد الله أيامنا وأيامكم، وكل عام وأنتم بخير، وتقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. I was told to speak a couple of words in English as well. As you know, this mosque, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, we do change a channel from one language to the next. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم إذا ظهرت في أمتي عشر خصال عاقبهم الله بعشر خصال، قيل وما هي يا رسول الله؟ قال إذا قللوا الدعاء نزل البلاء، وإذا تركوا الصدقات كثر الأمراض، وإذا منعوا الزكاة هلكت المواشي. I will continue the rest inshallah. Every one of them we explain a bit. We have just graduated from the holy month of Ramadan, and we have fasted this month, in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. So alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, we are in the graduation ceremony. We have learned many things in the month of Ramadan, and our soul has been cleansed. We have gone through a month of rehab. We have learned from recitation of the holy book Quran al-Kareem that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. Recitation of the holy book Quran al-Kareem, recitation of the أدعية, supplication, دعاء الافتتاح, دعاء جوشن الكبير, دعاء أبي حمزة الثمالي, and the other supplications, the soul that we have now has been changed.
He has gone through a cleansing phase. Now this is in your hands. You have just started a new month, the month of Shawwal. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam in this very tradition has said that my ummah, if they do 10, 10 will be done to them. A punishment phase. One, إِذَا قَلَّلُوا الدُّعَاء. If they decrease the supplication. You have started the month of Ramadan, the month of Rajab, Sha'ban and Ramadan with supplications, with recitation of many du'a. Now you have entered the month of Shawwal. We don't close shop and put it all on the side and we say we don't see the holy book, Quran al-Kareem, or Mafatih al-Jannah until the next year. This has changed you, this holy month. This beautiful atmosphere that you went through, the beautiful aroma of the holy month of Ramadan has made you a greater person. Rasulullah says that if this ummah of mine, they decrease their dua, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to them calamities. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sends to them bala. So what do? We continue with dua, with supplication to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِذَا تَرَكُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ كَثُرَ الْأَمْرَاضِ. I was just told before the Salat al-Eid that COVID has come back. So what does it say here? تَرَكُوا الصَّدَقَاتِ كَثُرَ الْأَمْرَاضِ. With sadaqah, you can stop all of that. Sadaqah, donation in the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The other one is a compliment for this one as well. وَإِذَا مَنَعُوا الزَّكَاةِ هَلَكَتْ الْمَوَاشِي. زَكَاةً and صَدَقَةً. Given in the face of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. One of the a'mal of today, of Eid al-Fitr al-Mubarak, is giving out zakat al-Fitrah. And it's a wajib compulsory act that the Imam says, Imam al-Sadiq, if you don't pay zakat al-fitra, as if you haven't fasted the holy month of Ramadan. So we have to sign off with your supplication, your dua, and your fasting with zakat al-fitra. That's one. The other one is, we have Ramadan hampers. Sana Ramadani. And we don't have Shawwal hampers. Why? What, we don't have the Hijjah hampers, the Qa'dah hampers. Our brothers and sisters overseas, they are in need throughout the year for help. Especially in this harsh winter, the harsh atmosphere, the harsh areas they're living in Yemen, in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in Iran. Some of them, they don't eat meat products for 6-7 months and ongoing. For us to give some sadaqah, for us to give some zakat, this is a necessary act. We have started the holy month of Ramadan with sadaqah and with zakat, we're ending it. Now we continue for the month of Shawwal. For today, zakat is the first. And how much is zakat? $15. If you go to St. George area, it might be $10. But here in MacArthur region, it's 15. So put away the zakat, give it away, zakat al-fitra, and this is a necessary, wajib, compulsory act. In addition to sadaqat, teaching our young children, the young ones, to pay the zakat, to pay the sadaqah, for them to put it away, this is a necessary act. In this very mosque, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, throughout the month of Ramadan that we had programmed, with Qari Rashid reciting Quran al-Kareem, Dua al-Iftitah, and the lectures and Q&As, we saw the number of the young man and woman increasing in this very mosque. And this is needed. And I add to this, sadaqah coming from the father, from the mother, is important. But sadaqah coming from the father and the mother, given to the children, for them to pay the sadaqah in the name of the Imam, Imam al-Hujjah alayhi wa salatu wa salam, is a necessary act. Because you're teaching them. You teaching them. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, in the end of time, it will be the worst of the worst. People will see ma'ruf as munkar and munkar as ma'ruf. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, radwanullah ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, right next to the Prophet, he said, Ya Rasulullah, wama yaf'alun? What do they do? What is the action they do? The Prophet said, if'alu al-khayr, do good. You do good, your children learn from that. That's what the Prophet said. The father, when he gets up to pray salat on its time, salat al-fara'id and even the mustahabbat, when the mu'adhin recites the adhan, the child also joins in for salat. Not that at the time of salat, the father is sitting down watching a game or watching some Netflix shows or such and such, and the child looks around, well, the salat is not on its time. Instead of Quran recitation at the house and the ad'iyah recitation at the house, what we have? We have music recitation. We have the lyrics of this singer and the other singer taking over the atmosphere of the house. The barakah of the house goes. The blessing of the house goes. Blessing of the house goes with this act. When you put Quran, when you put ad'iyah, when you bring them to the mosque, and you have this mosque, you have the other centers, for them to enter to this mosque and be among the gatherings, for them to listen to a lecture, even if the lecture was a boring lecture, even if the lecture is a long lecture, and everyone wants to go and have something to eat, even if that is the case, for them to be here, and you might think they don't understand this lecture or that lecture. No, they do understand. اِفْعَلُ الْخَيْرُ Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, do good and they learn the acts of good. The child learns it. The child follows it. That's why Rasulullah says, خَيْرُكُمْ مَنْ تَعَلَّمَ الْقُرْآنُ وَعَلَّمَهُ Amir al-Mu'mineen on his deathbed on the 21st of the month of Ramadan said, Allah, Allah fi al-Qur'an. لا يسبقكم به غيركم. This very Quran that we recite in the holy month of Ramadan, don't neglect it, recite it every day. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wa salam says, whoever doesn't recite 100 verses of the holy book a day is not one of our Shia. And I make it easy, I already said that in the lectures, 100 verses of the holy book. 96 verses are Surah Al-Waqi'ah and 4 are Surah Al-Ikhlas. That's 100 verses a day. And in addition to that, Allah increases your substance, your rizq, and reciting with the family, not by yourself, with the family. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, وَإِذَا كَثُرَ الرِّبَى كَثُرَةِ الزَلَازِلِ For every sin there is a side effect. For every sin. I'm not going to go through all of 10 of them because it's going to take a lot of your time, brothers and sisters. So the Prophet says, وَإِذَا كَثُرَ الرِّبَى كَثُرَةِ الزَّلَازِلِ And this year and the years before, you see that earthquakes have increased and it has become more severe and violent. And as they bring these very sins, they bring these calamities. And the Prophet is saying it to you and he has made it very clear. وَإِذَا نَقَضُوا أَحْدَ اللَّهِ ابْتَلَاهُمُ اللَّهُ بِالْقَتْلِ وَإِذَا طَفَفُوا الْكَيْلَ أَخَذَهُمُ اللَّهُ بِالسِّنِينَ ثُمَّ قَرَأَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَآلِهِ وَسَلَّمْ ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ بِمَا كَسَبَتْ أَيْدِ النَّاسِ ظَهَرَ الْفَسَادُ فِي الْبَرِّ وَالْبَحْرِ And let me make this clear. We are celebrating today Eid al-Fitr. And أسعد الله أيامنا وأيامكم again. وتقبل الله منا ومنكم صالح الأعمال. But remember this. During the holy month of Ramadan, we had a lot of lectures, programs, and some centers, they go back to the same programs they had before the month of Ramadan. Once a week, one lecture. Once a fortnight, one lecture, as if this one lecture that is 30 minutes is going to do a lot of difference. It's not going to make a lot of difference. The other side is spending billions of dollars and spending thousands of hours to draw in your children toward them. If you look at social media, If you look at the streaming giants, and today if you don't hold on to your children, they go. And tomorrow you say it's the fulan's problem and the fulan's issue and the fulan's fault. No, it's not anyone's fault except for yours and your child's fault. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that take over the charge of the children. Don't let them go astray one to the other. And we recite in Surah Al-Fatiha, اهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. How many times do we recite Surah Al-Fatiha throughout the day? We have 5 of the fara'id. Every one of them you have to recite in every rak'ah. So all together, how many times? 10, yes? And you recite it here and there. It's not one time. It's not 2 times. It's 10 times. This body of yours needs that alert, that shock every now and then. That's why you see the holy month of Ramadan. Right after that, what do you have? You have Hajj. Allahumma rizukna Hajj baytikal haram. The Imam said, Imam al-Sadiq, whoever doesn't get repentance in the holy month of Ramadan, he might get the repentance on Eid al-Fitr. If he doesn't get the repentance on Eid al-Fitr, forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he might go to Yom Arafah. And if he doesn't reach Yom al-Arafah, he goes to the next year, holy month of Ramadan. Now I ask you a question and you tell your answer to me or to yourself. Are you going to be alive in 1 hour? Maybe another day? You're not certain. So these moments they come, these very seconds they come and go. The Prophet said in the beginning of the month of Ramadan, Anfasukum fi tasbih, wa naumukum fi ibadah. Month of Ramadan left. لياليه أفضل الليالي وأيامه أفضل الأيام. Let's see. Tomorrow, if you go, even today, if you put your head down and you sleep, there is no going to be in نومكم فيه عبادة. The excuses that you had before that this is عبادة, let me take another 2-3 hours, has gone. So this is a point that a person has to look at. First thing first, ourselves, and then our children, and helping out the community to thrive. The programs of the community to thrive, this ongoing and coming, the problems that we have, Fulan said this, and the other one said that, and the other one said this, this is from Shaitan. And if we want to look at who said what, and who said what, and who said this, and who came there, and who came here, believe me, tomorrow, no one comes to this mosque. No one goes to any center. No one comes to any center, and this is something small here or there. He didn't say salam to me, he didn't say hi to me, he didn't say as'ad Allah ayyamakum. He came before me and he prayed and I was standing there before him. He took the water for me. What, this is childish acts that some people have. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, if Allah puts forward all of your amal, you wouldn't even bury each other. But he made it what? He made it concealed. سَتَرَ عَوْرَتَكُمْ سَتَرَ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. And also you do the same for the others. احْمَلْ أَخِيكَ عَلَى سَبْعِينَ مَحْمِلْ. The Imam said, Imam al-Sadiq, that make excuses for your brothers and sisters, 70 excuses. The Imam was told, one of the companions said to him, even if I see it with my eyes, or I hear it with my ears? The Imam said, yes. Even if that happens, you tell your eyes they lied and tell your ears they listened wrong. And you make another excuse for your brothers and sisters. So first thing first, brothers and sisters, أسعد الله أيامنا وأيامكم وكل عام وأنتم بخير. Also, don't forget Zakat al-Fitr. Again, it's $15, not less than that. We want to accept less than that. And up, and the up. Well, it depends how many children you have.
San George,
no, خلاص. They had the Siyam finished yesterday. The Eid was yesterday. So here in Campbelltown, we have it today. So Zakat al-Fitr is first thing first. The other one, as a request from the brothers from this very mosque, this mosque continues with your contribution, with your donation. And the holy month of Ramadan, if you came to the mosque, you said, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, it was packed with the young adults. We had many programs. We want to continue with these programs. So be generous helping this mosque. This is your mosque. It's a mosque of Imam al-Hujjah alayhi al-Salati wa salam. It's not for any person, any race, or that's what we do, three languages, Arabic, Farsi, and English. And I do apologize to the brothers, they know Urdu, I don't know Urdu. I tried once, but I gave up. And I'm very busy to learn Urdu. But this is the three languages that we give out in this mosque, and the Salat al-Jum'ah continues, inshallah. Please come. I take about 2 hours with Salat al-Jum'ah. And the khutab, inshallah, you all come here for Salat al-Jum'ah. And for the lessons that we have for the recitation of the holy book. And of course, Dua al-Kumail and the lectures, inshallah, in English and other languages, inshallah. Again, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you and all of your loved ones hidayah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yarzuqana ziyarat al-Husayn wa fil akhirati shafa'at al-Husayn. I just go through very quickly some of the a'mal, very quickly. Now when you say, Sayyid, you took a lot of our time, don't worry. After that, you're free to go. Ziyarat al-Imam al-Husayn is the first amal of this day. We already recited Ziyarat al-Imam al-Husayn. The other one, al-Ghusl, if you haven't done Ghusl, please do the Ghusl. Other amal is Ikhraj Zakat al-Fitra, as I mentioned. Salat al-Eid, we just recited Salat al-Eid. Taqabbalallahu a'malakum. Al-Iftar awwal al-Nahar. If you haven't broken your fast yet, have some of the Turba of Imam al-Husayn, salamullah alayhi. Nawfal said to Imam al-Sadiq, I had some of the Turba of Imam al-Husayn on Eid. Eid al-Fitr, the Imam said, you have combined Barakah and the Sunnah together with eating some of the Turba of Imam al-Husayn. Tahseen al-Thiyab, wearing the best of the clothing, and especially for your children, buy them the best of the clothing. Dua al-Nudba, we already, alhamdulillah, recited that. If you haven't, please do recite. And the takbir that we did, and istamal al-tayyib. Allahumma ajjil liwaliyyika al-faraj. Allahumma ajjil farajah wa sahhil makhrajah wa ij'alna min ansarihi wa a'wanihi ya rabbal alamin. Ya Allah, ya Rahman, ya Rahim, ya muqallib al-qulub, thabbit qalbi ala deenik. Brothers and sisters, because we heard some cases have risen with COVID, please, no hugging. I know you want to hug and kiss. Do it from far away. Yes? Be careful. We don't want to spread this around. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma kulla waliyyaka al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan. Salawatuka alayhi wa ala abaih fi hadhihi al-sa'a wa fi kulli sa'a. Waliyan wa hafidha wa qaidan wa nasira. ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا يا رب الحسين بحق الحسين اشف صدر الحسين بظهور الحجة الفاتحة قبلها الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد